Hey guys, I'm Julia and today I've got five of my favorite bass lines for you that I came across recently. I've been traveling a lot in the last couple of months and I finally had some time to listen to more music, and I've got a list where I write down all the songs that really got me. And so I also have a list for songs I want to play to. So today I'm going to show you five songs I really want to play to when I heard it for the first time. So I hope you'll like it as much as I do. Is on the fifth studio album from Mac Miller. It's called Swimming and it was released in August 2018. If you listen closely to the song, you can hear that the bass line is playing part of the melody line. So that's a pretty cool thing. And who played bass, ladies and gentlemen? Thundercat. So I really adore him. Thundercat really sticks to the groove, so there are just a few, really a few variations. But he's playing the groove through the whole song. Try it out and just sit there and play the groove for hours. I've done that, it's so much fun. This song was Reaching Too Much from Anderson .Paak featuring Layla Hathaway, released this year in April, and I just love the combination. I love Layla Hathaway and I love Anderson .Paak. I know exactly when I saw him for the first time. I went to a Bruno Mars concert actually, and I have to be honest and say I didn't know Anderson .Paak before, and he was like the opening act. And he totally killed it, and since then I'm a big Anderson .Paak fan and this song really got me. Joe Dart, that's all I have to say. Thank you. up Lewis Cole live sesh on YouTube. He put it on YouTube last year and it just says recorded in some guy's house. You definitely have to watch it. There are some crazy things going on there and you will definitely not get everything by watching it by the first time. The bass player is Sam Wilkes. He's a unique sound, phrasing is great, groove, really cool feels and bass lines. So really go and watch it. It's definitely worth it. It's the oldest one out of these five. It's from Herbie Hancock. It's on the album Trust. It is not easy to play, especially, for example, go into the rehearsal room with your drummer and try it out. It's not easy to get the bassline and the drum groove together. Both of them are very complicated and you really have to get the 16th notes together. So that's the most important thing and not easy. Try it. What all bass lines have in common is that they are played through the whole song. So we have, for example, Mac Miller, we have got a 4-bar groove which is repeated the whole time. So if you've never done that before, just sit down and take your favorite song, break it down to the main groove and try to play that groove for about 10 or 20 minutes. And you will see you will go through different stages. At least that's my feeling when I play a groove or when I'm practicing a groove. I just sit down. The first minute, it feels like, okay, it's pretty good, feels good. Then after two more minutes, it is like, okay, I can't play at all. What am I doing right now? And then after three or four or five more minutes, I begin to understand how the groove is working. I'm listening to the drums more or what's going on and what is the phrasing about. So it's really worth sitting down and just play the groove for more than 10 minutes. So if you haven't done that before, try it out, sit down, get your metronome or get your backing track, for example, and just concentrate to one groove. So I hope you like the songs as much as I do, and we're planning to do this more often. If you don't want to miss videos like that, be sure to hit the subscribe button and ring the bell, and I really hope to see you next time. Mwah.